Please be seated. Good evening, and welcome to the Lamar University College of Arts and Science Commencement Ceremony, May 20th, 2016. My name is Paul Benazzani, and I serve as Interim Associate Dean for the College of Arts and Sciences. We have gathered on this special occasion to acknowledge and to honor our graduates for their tireless efforts, remarkable dedication, and deserved achievements in the demanding and competitive arena of higher education. For years, our graduates have been striving to reach the educational milestones that we celebrate this evening. Graduates, this phase of your life's journey is now complete. Sincere congratulations to each of you. However, we now challenge you to continue to learn, to apply your knowledge and to excel throughout your personal and professional lives. Tonight, the college will recognize 521 graduates who will receive 524 degrees. Our graduates come from 6 countries outside of the United States, from 15 states other than Texas, and from 108 cities and towns from every region within our state. Our commencement ceremony will honor students from Alvin to Albania, from Nederland to the Netherlands, and from Village Mills to Vietnam. Candidates, many people have supported you throughout your life and studies, and I would like for you to please join me as we express our appreciation to them. Will the parents of our candidates please stand and receive our applause? Will the grandparents of our candidates please stand and receive our applause? Will the spouses, children, and grandchildren of our candidates please stand and receive our applause? And will the friends and other relatives of our candidates please stand and receive our applause? This evening, we share the joy of commencement with all of you. Thank you for celebrating with us. At the heart of Lamar University is a supportive and nationally acclaimed faculty. They have provided our graduates with a contemporary and valuable higher education that is second to none. Due to the diligence and efforts of Lamar faculty, our graduates are knowledgeable, highly skilled, and fully prepared for life and careers. Will our faculty please stand and be recognized? Thank you, and please be seated. And now, please welcome Dr. Joe Norgren, Interim Dean of the College of Arts and Sciences.
Good evening. Welcome. Permit me to add my personal congratulations to all of you. At this time, it's my honor to introduce the platform participants for this evening's event. As I call your names, will the platform members in row one please rise and remain standing. To my right, in row one, Dr. Kenneth R. Evans, President of Lamar University. Dr. James Marquardt, Provost and Vice President for Academic Affairs. Dr. Kevin Smith, Senior Associate Provost. Dr. Brenda Nichols, Associate Provost. Dr. Cruz Melvin, Vice President for Finance and Operations. Dr. Tom Sowers, President of the Faculty Senate and Associate Professor, Department of Political Science. To my left, Mr. Sean Cunningham, JD, Texas State University System, Vice Chancellor for Governmental Relations. Mr. John Zerwas, MD, Texas House State of Representatives, Chairman of the House Committee on Higher Education, and also our guest speaker for this evening. Mr. Juan Zabala, Vice President for University Advancement. Ms. Jordan Danielle Price, Student Guest Speaker. And you have already met Dr. Paul Bernazzani, Interim Associate Dean, College of Arts and Sciences. Row one may be seated. As I call your names, Will the platform members in row two now rise and please remain standing? To my right, in row two, Dr. William Harn, Dean of Graduate Studies. Dr. Cynthia Stinson, Chair, Joanne Gay Dishman, Department of Nursing. Dr. Mary E. Wilkinson, Chair, Department of Mathematics. Ms. Julie Alford, Director of Advising, Bachelor of Applied Arts and Sciences, and Bachelor of General Studies. Ms. Abigail Dupin, Assistant Professor of Voice. To my left in row two, Dr. Kevin Dodson, Dean, Rio Honors College. Dr. Paul Nicoletto, Chair, Department of Biology. Dr. Zi Yang Li, Interim Chair, Department of Chemistry and Biochemistry. Dr. Stefan Andre, Chair, Department of Computer Science. Dr. Jim Jordan, Chair, Department of Earth and Space Sciences. Row two may be seated. As I call your names, will the platform members in row three please rise and remain standing? I did not finish first in my class, by the way. To my right in row three, Dr. Edith Kirk, Chairman, Department of Psychology. Dr. Richard Lumpkin, Interim Chair, Department of Physics. Dr. Terry Davis, Chair, Department of Political Science. To my left in row three, Dr. Stuart Wright, Chair, Department of Sociology, Social Work, and Criminal Justice. Dr. Mary Shearer, Chair, Department of History. Dr. Jim Sanderson, Chair, Department of English and Modern Languages. Dr. Catalina Castillon, Associate Professor of Spanish, and one of our readers. Mr. Jesse Duran, Instructor of English, and also one of our readers. Mr. David Short, University Registrar. Row three, please be seated. It is likewise my pleasure to recognize Dr. Scott Deppe and members of the Lamar University Brass Ensemble. Their performance adds so much to this wonderful occasion. Thank you. A few special guests also have joined us this evening. Mr. Dade Phelan, Texas State Representative, District 21. Mrs. Cecilia Marquardt. Mrs. Lee Smith, and Mrs. Sylvia Zerwas. Thank you for celebrating with us tonight. Graduates, including those who will be participating online, this evening you're at the very center of our attention, and what a wonderful, remarkable group of people you happen to be. Just reflect for a moment, if you will. While many of you are embracing the opportunity to study abroad, and journey away from Southeast Texas, perhaps for the first time in your lives. There were others who were boarding planes on the distant continents of Asia and Europe and hoping to find a home on our campus. They have. While some of you have been working tirelessly to prepare for law or medical school, others have been equally dedicated to begin their future careers in scientific research or in social services. And while many of you this evening will be earning membership into a long-standing family tradition of success in higher education, an equal, if not larger, number of you will be starting a family tradition as first-generation college graduates. You may have doubted that this moment would ever arrive. It has, and you own it. The success that each of you has earned cannot be taken from you. Why? Because you have shown excellence in everything that you have attempted, and you have attempted a great deal. Yet excellence just is not about meeting your responsibilities. It is also about holding yourself accountable for how you interact with others and how you navigate through difficult circumstances. By definition, commencement is a beginning, not an end. Therefore, the diploma that you are about to receive not only symbolizes excellence at its highest level, but it also symbolizes a commitment to apply your knowledge and talent to the fullest of your abilities. From this day onward, you will forever be identified with the legacy of Lamar University. And to cultivate that legacy, you now stand poised, ready to invent the future. Be proud of yourselves, for we certainly are proud for you. I'm honored at this time to introduce tonight's commencement speaker, Dr. John Zerwas, whose accomplishments, both past and present, reveal a dedication to personal and civic excellence. Dr. Zerwas earned his MD from Baylor College of Medicine in 1980 and has been practicing physician for the past 30 years. More than a decade ago, he co-founded a Houston area group practice, and he remains actively involved in that partnership. Dr. Zerwas is past president of the American Society of Anesthesiologists and has previously served as chief medical officer of the Memorial Hermann Hospital System. In addition to these accomplishments as a physician, Dr. Zerwas is proudly serving his fifth legislative term as the Texas House of Representatives. Dr. Zerwas's constituency includes Texas House District 28, which encompasses northwestern Fort Bend County and is one of the fastest growing regions in our state. He currently presides as chairman of the House Committee on Higher Education, which is fitting, given his advocacy for increasing access to higher education and for growing opportunities for graduate medical education. In addition to his honorable assignment, he also sits on the Committee of Public Health, where he brings firsthand experience and knowledge of healthcare systems and policy to the committee. Representative Zerwas is one of four doctors in the Texas House of Representatives. His expertise is critically important at a time when health and human services is one of the fastest growing areas of state spending. He's received numerous honors for his dedication to public service. They include the 2014 Coalition of Texans with Disabilities Award, the 2014 American Cancer Society Action Award, and twice being named among the 10 best legislators by Texas Monthly. In 2015, the biotechnology industry organization nationally recognized Dr. Zerwas as Bio-Legislator of the Year for writing critical legislation that will preserve patient access to innovative and cost-effective biological medicines in Texas. Please join me in welcoming our distinguished guest speaker, Dr. John Zerwas.
Well, good evening, and thank you for the kind introduction, Doctor, and what a privilege it is to be with y'all here today on what is truly one of your most momentous occasions in your life. Representative Phelan was recognized earlier. Dade sits right across the aisle from me in the Texas House of Representatives. We spend a lot of time together talking about issues. The people in Beaumont are incredibly well represented by him, and I just want to shout that out to him right now because I consider it a privilege to get to work with him on a number of big issues that we have. President Evans, thank you for the opportunity to be here. Your leadership has been enormous in the development of Lamar University. Members of the faculty, Lamar University wouldn't exist without you. The accolades given to you are appropriately earned, and the recognition by your students, now your colleagues, I would say, is most appropriate, and certainly everybody here that is here to recognize this great event is part and parcel connected to somebody in this group sitting right down here in front of me. And so I tell you, this is one of the most momentous times in your life. I've had a few graduations myself. I tell you, they rank up there with my marriage, my spouse. Always remember that, graduates, when you're recognizing momentous occasions, always remember the spouse is part of that momentous time. The birth of your children is another one of those times that there are things that you just don't forget as a consequence of the hard work that you put in out here. And so I'm very, very proud to be here and be part of this this great celebration. I need to make a few disclaimers here. First of all, Dr. Evans made it very clear, 8 to 10 minutes, Dr. Zarwas, you know, that's what we want here for you. And I know, judging by the applause Jordan Price got, she's the one you really want to hear. And so I will definitely stick to my 8 to 10 minutes. And number two, as was mentioned, they told you I'm a medical doctor. That's what I spent 4 years after college getting a degree, and then 4 years after that doing a residency in surgery and anesthesiology. So what that tells you is that for the past 30 years, I have been totally focused on putting people to sleep. That's what I do. So yeah, Dr. Evans, I'm not sure why I would be the person that you would want up here. I have seen people's eyelids droop in front of me many, many times a day, thousands of times over my career. I will say, in order to be brief, I'm very quick to recognize drooping eyelids. I'm very quick to recognize yawns. And I look at that as a signal that, okay, your 8 to 10 minutes is up, buddy. Let's move on with this. And so let me go ahead and move through this a little bit with you here. We're going to have a little fun with some of the things that I'm going to share with you. You know, it really is a very, very deep honor. I'm very humbled by the opportunity to come speak at these types of ceremonies. I also know it's nothing to do with me. This crowd here today is here because of your accomplishment for the years that you put in at Lamar University, completing a very, very rigorous, very, very rigorous curriculum. You know, and I've often thought when I get asked to do these, you know, who were the guest speakers at my commencements in high school, in college, in medical school? We don't have them in residency. We're just glad to get out and get a real job. But I don't remember who the commencement speaker is. You know, I don't remember my children's commencement speakers. I don't remember my grandchildren's commencement speakers and stuff. But one thing that you need to remember from this, and you're going to hear it not just from me, you've already heard it from some of the people up here, you're going to hear it from your faculty. Never, never underestimate the gift of knowledge that Lamar University has given you. Never, never forget that. I will never forget the gift of knowledge at the University of Houston, Baylor College of Medicine, and UT Health Science Center in San Antonio gave me. There is no way that I would have been able to take the next steps without that. So always remember that is a gift that you've been given. You have earned it. You have paid for it. But it is something that it will forever be of value to you. The state of Texas has come to expect great things from people from this institution. And I'm certain that the investment that you have made, your family has made, will benefit not just you, it'll benefit not just your family, but it's going to benefit many Texans and many people around this great nation. I've tailored my comments, brief as they'll be, around several quotes from some very unique, somewhat unrelated individuals, if you will. that have certainly made their mark in the world. And they have been very, very valuable to me as I've kind of looked at things that have guided me. Jack Welch is the first one, who is the incredibly successful CEO of General Electric for over two decades. He has many aphorisms that sort of credited to him, but one of them is this. It's the first and one that you really need to, I think you already have done to some extent. Control your destiny or someone else will. Now, I don't know what your various dreams are. I don't know what your ambitions are. But what I do know is that knowledge gives you a distinct advantage to control your destiny. And graduates from this university are highly sought after because they, in fact, have the accomplishment that you have here today. Now, in many ways, you're going to be asked to take leadership roles as you engage in the many changes, the certain changes that are going to come in the future. So the next quote comes from somebody that you'll never recognize his name. He's a British field marshal named Bernard Montgomery. Found this in a book called The 21 Indispensable Qualities of Leadership. And the quote addresses first and probably the most important quality of leadership. It goes like this, so hang in there with me with it. It says, leadership is the capacity and the will to rally men and women to a common purpose and the character which inspires confidence. It's the capacity and the will to rally men and women to a common purpose and the character that is going to inspire confidence. Now, regardless of your life's journey, you and your professional career, you are going to be asked to take on leadership roles. You may not want them, you may grouse about them, but you're going to be asked to take them on. And it may take the form of a company initiative, it may take the form of a volunteer effort, military obligations, perhaps public service, which I found myself in about a decade ago. And though there's many experiences that are going to contribute to that will and that capacity that the field marshal relates to, and perhaps even a greater number of experiences that contribute to your character, I am convinced that the time here at Lamar University will be a defining part of your leadership journey. When I'm asked by my peers how I ended up in the various leadership roles that I have, I'm quick to say that I certainly did marry over my head and that the real brains were certainly my wife, and that was her ambitions. But I also noted to myself that I found myself, when these opportunities arise, saying yes more than I said no. And as these opportunities arise in your life and during your leadership journey, be confident knowing that your education through Lamar University has contributed to that will, to that capacity, and to that character that will rally others to a common purpose and a common vision. A third quote comes from a well-known speechwriter, William Manchester. I found this in an essay way, way back when most of y'all weren't born, 1990. And his topic was reflections on the changes in our society from 1930 to 1990, 60 years. A lot of changes happened during that time. A lot of changes continue to happen. But what he noticed most importantly was the single constant was change that occurred. And most importantly, it was the increasing rate of change that was evident in that 60 years and obviously what we're seeing now. Here's his quote. If the American of the 21st century plans to succeed amid the accelerations of the next century, he or she must be supple and malleable to change, cloaked in resilience and not in self-righteousness. Cloaked in resilience and not self-righteousness. Today, you are among the most highly educated in this country, if not in the world. And for that, you should be very proud. But likewise, be prepared to build upon this gift of knowledge, such that the certain changes in the future don't leave you behind in a cloak of self-righteousness. Now, throughout my own career, the greatest rewards have certainly come from service to others. It is not a complete commencement address without giving some admonition to give back, you know, some of what you've been given, certainly some of what you have earned. I have found that opportunity in medical missions down in Guadalajara, down in Guatemala, and other places like that, where they don't have, obviously, the medical facilities that we have in this country. It's a great, great energizing thing for me to be able to do that. I do that because it's something I want to give back to, and it's something that I truly do get something out of. You will find those same things. I don't know what they're going to be, but you're going to do them not because you're asked to do them. You're going to do it because of it's a personal calling. And so let me share with you a couple of quotes from some very, very notable individuals that speak to this. Albert Schweitzer is the 1952 Nobel Peace Prize winner. He's a very accomplished musician. He's a philosopher, a physician, a theologian. He could have enjoyed the best that life had to offer at that particular time. But what did he choose to do? He chose to open a medical clinic on one of the most destitute parts of Western Central Africa. And this is one of his assertions. "I don't know what your destiny will be, but one thing I know, the ones among you who will be really happy are those who have sought and found how to serve." And the other individual on this subject is Professor Albert Einstein, 1921 Nobel Prize winner in physics. And he states the following. Now remember, this is a guy that's smarter than probably anybody in the world. This is a guy that can explain everything down to a molecular basis. Here's his comment. Think about this. "Strange is our situation here upon Earth. Each of us comes for a short visit, not knowing really why, yet sometimes seeming of a divine purpose. From the standpoint of daily life, there is one thing that we do know, that man is here for the sake of other men. And graduates from Lamar University will have a legacy of impacting humanity, both through your chosen profession, as well as a passion for benevolence and generosity. You're truly joining an exclusive group of women and men that will make this world a better place for generations to come." So finally, in the words that you've been yearning to hear, in closing, now, in my specialty, we call this emergence from anesthesia, okay? So I'm sitting there with a patient that's getting some horrendous thing done to him, and I'm keeping him asleep, hopefully. And at the end of that case, what I do is I turn off the gases that are keeping him asleep. I sometimes give him a little medicine to make him start breathing a little bit better. And boom, they wake up, their eyelids come up, they're no longer droopy-eyed, and hopefully they're saying, "Oh, this is great, I'm not feeling any pain at all." I hope you're not feeling any pain at all, because this is the conclusion of my remarks to you. So let me again congratulate you on this monumental achievement, and one that I know will make the world a better place. And after all these deep, thought-provoking quotes from really, truly remarkable individuals, the final and perhaps most instructive comes from an individual named Larry Bossidy, a former CEO of Allied Signal and a protege of Jack Welch. And he says this: "Be safe, have fun, and do great things. Graduates of Lamar University, you have been prepared to do just that. I congratulate you again on your wonderful accomplishment, and thank you for allowing me to be part of this momentous occasion." Thank you.
Thank you, Representative Zerwas, for your encouraging remarks and your invaluable support for healthcare and higher education. You have indeed transformed lives and set a wonderful example for our graduates to follow. Thank you. Tonight's student speaker, Ms. Jordan Price of Beaumont, Texas, was a graduate of Westbrook Senior High School. In her 4 years at Lamar University, she's maintained an unblemished grade point average and has dedicated her time outside of her studies to the service of her school, those in need, the community at large. She's been involved with several student organizations, including president of the Pan-Hellenic Council and various honor societies. She plans to attend dental school. I think you see a theme here tonight. She plans to attend dental school next year so she can follow a path committed to scientific advancement and service to others. Kindly welcome Ms. Jordan Price.
President Evans, Dean Nordgren, distinguished faculty, family, and fellow graduates, good evening. Ralph Waldo Emerson once said, "Do not go where the path may lead. Go instead where there is no path and leave a trail." After today, we all have the opportunity to be trailblazers, leaders who will make a way for others. We'll use the knowledge and experiences we have gained over the past few years to change the world. Of course, it would be easier to take the path of least resistance, but nothing worth having ever comes easy. Sitting here today, receiving your degree from this amazing university would not feel half as good if it was easy. So now we must ask ourselves, how is it possible for us to make a difference? Changing the whole world is a lofty goal. It may seem overwhelming or even impossible when you think of it like that. It's like trying to study for 3 tests and write a paper all at once. It only seems unmanageable until you realize you can only do 1 thing at a time. Similarly, having a true impact on this planet we call home is accomplished by changing the lives of 1 person at a time. Change is dependent on your ability to say yes to every opportunity before you have time to talk yourself out of it. Do not waste your life worrying how you will make it work. Do not allow yourself to get caught up in worst case scenarios. Just say yes and figure out the rest later. Just a few months ago, because of the opportunities I've received at Lamar University, I was presented with a chance to go to Guatemala on a dental mission trip. I had 10 minutes to decide if I was going to go or not. The director of the program was holding up the list and waiting for me to finalize it. So without thinking, I told him I was in. A few hours later, after making the confirmation, I realized I would be going to another country in less than 2 weeks with no idea where I would sleep, what I would be doing, knowing 0 people going on the trip, and to top it off, I had 3 exams the following week. Had I thought about all the things that could go wrong first, I might not have gone. Now I can honestly say it was one of the most rewarding experiences of my life. I made so many friends, and we helped over 1,000 children. The lives of over 1,000 children were made different because a few people decided to say yes to opportunity. When I was asked to be your speaker, feeling inspired by my "Say Yes to Everything, Say Yes to Opportunity" motto, I said, "Of course, I would love to." Then it really hit me that I would be speaking in front of thousands of people, and I felt a rush of nervousness. I began to think of how much I admired public speakers, and all the times I wondered how they could get up in front of so many people, hoping a few would receive their message. Then I realized they just did it. They just started saying yes without thinking, and they hoped for the best. I'm telling you today, this is the attitude we need to have in all aspects of our lives. Let your excitement for new adventure replace the fear of the unknown. And while you're out there making a name for yourself, let us not forget the place that made us who we are. In the experiences I have had going out into the world, I realized how much Lamar University has embraced the uniqueness of every student. Lamar is special in that I've never felt like just another student. Every one of my professors was always willing to do so much extra. Dr. Hyduk and Dr. Kuchnor not only gave me a vast wealth of biological knowledge, they included sage life advice in all of their classes. Dr. Christensen and Dr. Hoke, thank you for Belize and our research. You really changed my life. Dr. Davis taught me to take risks and put myself out there. She encouraged me to be a strong, independent woman and to recognize, while it's okay to be humble, it was necessary to acknowledge my accomplishments. I will never forget you. Finally, Dr. Nicoletto and Dr. Bernazzani, thank you for always going above and beyond for your students. I have had so many once-in-a-lifetime opportunities because I chose to attend school here, and I am so glad that I did. I would not be the person that I am today if I would have gone anywhere else. While all of us will go on to do great things, we have to always remember our roots and Lamar University that gave us our foundation. In his final commencement address, Steve Jobs ended by saying, "Stay hungry, stay foolish." This has always resonated with me. At this point in our lives, we think that the large part of our education is over, but that is so far from the truth. We have to stay hungry for knowledge and ambitious for improvement. More importantly, though, stay foolish. People have a tendency as they go through life to start seeing the world in a negative light and think that they, as just one person, could never change any of it. This way of thinking becomes a self-fulfilling prophecy. So with this in mind, try to see the good in everything you come across and in every person you meet, because the people foolish enough to think that they can change the world are always the ones who do. Leave here today with a childlike foolishness and a fire in your heart for greatness, knowing that you and only you have the power to create the world that you wish to live in. Thank you and congratulations, graduating class of 2016. We did it.
Thank you, Jordan, for reflecting on the distinctive type of education that you received here at Lamar. Sincere best wishes as you pursue dental school. Say yes to everything. Take chances. Excel. We will now continue with the certification of our graduates. Will the candidates for the master's degree and Dr. Bill Harn please rise and remain standing? When your department or program is called, will the candidates for the baccalaureate degrees please rise and also remain standing? The Department of Biology and Dr. Paul Nicoletto. The Department of Chemistry and Biochemistry and Dr. Xing Yang Li. The Department of Computer Science and Dr. Stefan Andre. The Department of Earth and Space Sciences and Dr. Jim Jordan. The Department of English and Modern Languages and Dr. Jim Sanderson. Applied Arts and Sciences and General Studies, Ms. Julie Alford. The Department of History and Dr. Mary Shear. The Department of Mathematics and Dr. Mary E. Wilkinson. The Joanne Gay Dishman Department of Nursing and Dr. Cynthia Stinson. The Department of Physics and Dr. Richard Lumpkin. The Department of Political Science and Dr. Terry Davis. The Department of Psychology and Dr. Edith Kirk. The Department of Sociology, Social Work, and Criminal Justice and Dr. Stuart Wright. President Evans, on behalf of the faculty of the College of Arts and Sciences, I am pleased to verify the candidates who have met all of the requirements for their listed degrees.
Thank you, Dean Norgren. This is the coolest part of my job. I'm going to tell you that right now. By the authority vested in me and Lamar University by the Board of Regents of the Texas State University System, I confer upon you the degree for which you have been certified, admitting you to all the rights and privileges which throughout the world pertain to those degrees. Graduates, keeping with university tradition and symbolizing change, please move your tassel from the right to the left on your cap. Needless to say, congratulations.
President Evans and Interim Dean Norgren, we will now continue with the presentation of the graduating class of May 2016. Beginning with the College of Graduate Studies and followed by the academic departments in the order in which they are published in the program. Please sit down. Sorry. Thank you.
Master of Science in Chemistry. Sri Priya Artham. Venkatarangara Ataluri. Kirti Badgujard. Radhika Ganjaneni. Sravani Gatamaneni. Ravi Mane. Sravanthi Reddy Naini. Pranathi Reddy Sala. Anusha Vem. Master of Science in Computer Science. Rachana Reddy Bimreddy. Leila Boti. Harshitha Vas Chirla. Kaushal Daruri. Mayur N. Chovatia. Teja Sweeney Divya. Ananya Dutta. Venkata Narayana Ega. Eshwar Ratan Kumar Gopishetty. Swarupa Reddy Gudi Metla. Tejaswi Sri Sai Gudi Pudi. Pramod Jangam. Girish Kumar Kadiyala. Narendra Kumar Pravinbhai Lakhani. Durga Bhavani Kaluri. Ramakrishna Reddy Murthala. Prudvi Prakash Lanki Palasadala Gurupa. Giraj Nagaruju. Aditya Narayanan. Umran Nurali. Harshil Bharatbhai Parik. Adi Kumar Deepak Bhai Patel. Abhinay Kartik Reddy Gade. Nitesh Reddy Chopa. Jayakantilal Patel. Arnob Saha. Jigar Nilesh Shah. Salman Vazirali Siddiq. Bhavana Banala. Kartik Girdhar. Saurabh Pradeep Kulkarni. Kyatibin D. Patel. Sindhu Raghavi Puram. Ganga Deep Singh Shran. Master of Science, Computer. Praveen Thirumalapadi. Sandeep Akiti. Master of Science in Computer Science, Akhil Adula. Harish Kumar Reddy Vasipalli. Sanjay Naka. Sampath Reddy Busu. Abhilash Kanamatha Reddy. Rajashekhar Bantu Pavan. Sai Mahit Vudi. Karthik Reddy Venkata Sai Puti. Niharika Reddy Gosukonda. Kavya Sri Musunuru. Venkata Rupa Rani Mudana. Master of Science in Chemistry. Srivarsha Panguluri. Bosu Vira Venkata Sai Navin Kumar Pamansetti. Master of Arts in English, Verity Claire Okaden. Victoria Ann Vandenberg. Master of Arts in Teaching Spanish as a Foreign Language, Miguel Sarsosa. Master of Science in Mathematics, Sarah Ann McQueen. Master of Science in Nursing, Kristen Ann Christian. Y- Yasmin Kanan. Brittany LaShawn Rhodes. Miranda Renee Tyner. Patricia Eileen Weissman. Beverly Jean Welch.
For the Master of Public Administration, Sarah R. Irwin. Alicia Ann Jones. Sarah Evelyn Joy Wallace. For the Master of Science in Applied Psychology, Candice Jessica Cutts. Bria Lynn Naomi Kunder. Kuyomoni N. Mickens. Chelsea Myers. Zachary Stewart Windsor. For the Master of Science in Criminal Justice, Maria C. Bednar. Matthew Philip Kaplan. Monique Latoya Carson. Celine El Amin. Kenico Jones. Christian Elizabeth Kirby. Andrea Ann McIntyre. Eric Wayne Mings. Rain Raven Perlick. Stephanie Marie Powell. Tiffany Chriselle Prosper. Justin L. Redin. Mona Lachelle Scott. Roger D. Taylor. Erica Eva Theodore. Rita Aisha Hope West. Casey Renee Willis. Michael Lee Hicks. Kenny V. Gonzalez. For the Bachelor of Science in Biology, Jessica Mackenzie Kroll. Cum laude. Also graduating summa cum laude, Jordan Danielle Price. Ryan Glenn Curran. Annette Nemiro Ikatan. Shaylee Adil Francois. With a second degree in political science, Emmy Ann Hammonds. a graduate from the Rio Honors College and summa cum laude, Tori Lynn Hoker. Also from the Rio Honors College, graduate Zach Holt. Han Kim Nguyen. Summa cum laude graduate, Momin Ul Islam. Summa cum laude graduate, Sucharita Marneni. Summa cum laude graduate, Shusmita Marneni. Claudia Maribel Marroquin. Graduated with cum laude, Haley Ann Matthews. Graduating magna cum laude, Julia Grace McKilwee. Graduating cum laude, Macy Taylor Reeves. Graduating summa cum laude, Rebecca A. Roden. Jonathan Simon Rubio. Graduating cum laude, Marisol Sanchez. Danish Shahzad. Magna cum laude, Scott Andrew Stewart. Graduating cum laude, Gina Marie Trehan. Graduating summa cum laude, Corny Marie Verma. For the Bachelor of Science in Environmental Science, Holden Everett Butler. For the Bachelor of Science in Chemistry, Timothy Wayne Brown. Mohanud Mohammed. Troy Paul Selby Kearney. For the Bachelor of Science in Forensic Chemistry, Michelle Felicia Ceja. For the Bachelor of Science in Computer Science and Mathematics, Gregory Yera. For the Bachelor of Science in Computer Science, Layla D. Dages. Timothy Joshua Holcomb. Timothy Shane Marburger. For the Bachelor of Arts in English, Shannon Cooper. Raven Nicole Duhon. Sarah Kathleen Moore. Aaron Levi Morris. Graduating summa cum laude, Delana Jordan Sauerwine. Bachelor of Arts in Mother Languages, graduating summa cum laude, Martha P. Amfoso Valdez. Brittany Diane Birdwell. Graduating from the Rio Honors College, and summa cum laude, Terrence Elizabeth Cobb. Graduating magna cum laude, Vanessa Hernandez Iglesias Sanchez. Denise Rosario Ledesma. For the Bachelor of Arts in History, graduating from the Rio Honors College and summa cum laude, Zachary Joseph DeFrancis. Graduating magna cum laude, Judith Elaine Nillens. Tyler J. Quibidol. For the Bachelor of Applied Arts and Sciences. Graduating magna cum laude, Casey H. Adams. Mayra Uresti Birdwell. Stephen Allen Coleman. Magna cum laude, Sharon Lynn Curry. Summa cum laude, Priscilla Alicia Denmon. Shelley Elaine Dilbeck. Maria Guadalupe Dominguez. Kelly Michelle Dowden. Barbara Lynn Fitzgerald. Sergio Flores Jr. Christina Rocha Foggy. Yvonne Marie Garza. Amy Lynn Gaskins. Bruce Edward Gibson Jr. Graduating cum laude, Alana Renee Hall. Jordan Ann Hibbert. Parker Jacob James. Mercedes Gabrielle Johnson. Jariah Lene Jones. Graduating magna cum laude, Anjanae Briche Mathis. Summa cum laude, Monica Lee Miller. Summa cum laude, Serena Claire Morrow. Debra Ann Neville. Tui Q. Thi Nguyen. For the Bachelor of Applied Arts and Sciences, Mahalia Alexandria Payne. Keith Garrett Payton. Christian Perkins. Shatara Lynn Pickens. Ashley Nicole Pinky. Graduating summa cum laude, Jason Christopher Prior. Dorkasha Aisha Richard. Nicole Candice Roman. Jacqueline Melissa Sanchez. Angela Michelle Sears. Carrie Ann Che. Renee D. Shepherd. Rachel Anna Marie Simmons. Thomas Errol Sunsell II. Graduating cum laude, Jennifer Megan Soto. Robin Gail Summers. Marshall Ray Swift. Graduating cum laude, Bonnie Beth Tierheimer. Ursula Elaine Thomas. Paula M. Vineman. Ashley Marie Werner. Carolyn Brown Zubeth.
Bachelor of General Studies. Kedrick Bernard Amadi Johnson. Hannah Marie Ashebrenner. Alluvia Patrice Blueford. Shanquail B. Bradford. Randolph Brandon Byers, Jr. Yolanda Gail Calvin. Kathleen M. Carlisle. Shelby Renee Clements. Brad Allen Croak. Tiffany Nicole Croak. Marcus Joseph Escalante. Tara B. Folk. Candace R. Gonzalez. Althea Carmelita Green. Wiona Ray Harris. Bally Lauren Honeycutt. English Lancon. Brent Anthony Nicholson. Ashley Nicole Norman. Taylor Elise Pfeiffer. Stacy Denise Perkins. Graduating cum laude, Sherry L. Poole. Crystal Renee Rogelio. Daniel Seth Rumsey. Dontavius Daryl Sears. Graduating summa cum laude, Morgan Rochelle Sessions. Dion Renee Tatum. Eustrada Reginald Taylor Jr. Brett Allen Tynert. Tiffany Jane Thompson. Jessica Nicole Tolbert. Danielle Lee Wyatt. Alexis L. Young. Bachelor of Arts in Mathematics. Shaniqua Monet Castile. Bachelor of Science in Mathematics. Chad Peter Bryan. Tyler Prescott Evans. Graduating with a second degree in computer science, Rio College graduate, summa cum laude, Jason Alexander Hatton. Graduating second degree in chemical engineering, Rio College honors, summa cum laude. Graduating summa cum laude, Elizabeth Rachel Newell. Graduating cum laude, Jonathan Isaac Ritchie. Bachelor of Science in Nursing, Taylor Abshire. Danielle Racine Heather Adams. Hannah Yvette Arnett. Rachel Marie Babineau. Jessica Faye Bailey. Adriana Latrice Baird. Kimberly Ann Bean. Jaime Duray Beceda. Lauren Danielle Bracken. Graduating magna cum laude, Jason Albert Broussard. Emosha Tashawn Williams. Morgan L. Burden. DeMarcus Jamal Bushnell. Cassandra Zemay Cannon. Jocelyn N. Causer. Karina Ruby Chavez. Pamela A. Collins. Graduating magna cum laude, Heidi Robinson Cooper. Faraz Farid Datu. Claudia Patricia De Los Reyes. Tiona Nicole Ferguson. Megan Dawn Fitzwater. Casey Lynn Gutierrez. Cody Richard Gutierrez. Yay! Saba Hale Michael. Ashley Nicole Aber. Kevin Ray Hoffpower. Bianca Blanchet Joseph. Graduating summa cum laude, Ryan Paul Kelly. Evan Elise Kohlhofer. Gina Marie LeHue. Graduating summa cum laude, Jordan Nicole Lynch. Chelsea Marie Maniscalco. Trang Thien Marino. Madeline Nicole Marlowe. Samantha Marie Martin. Shatana Renee Martin. Christopher Chase May. Morgan Loy McLean. Graduating cum laude, Maggie Marie McGee. Tiffany Lene McKnight. John Evan Michael Melling. Graduating cum laude, Larissa Barkley Monson. Jessica Michaeline Nitsch. Cody Nelms. Jonathan Tai Huo Nguyen. Susan R. Oler. Santana Nicole Olvera. Amber Shalice Owens. Paola Parra. Chastity Nicole Pierre. Kendall Joy Louise Prokop. Jesus Francisco Ramirez de la Torre. Rebecca Olivia Robinson. Amy Renee Roundtree. Kelsey Elizabeth Shepherd. Kayla Marie Shoemaker. Stephen Charles Sutton. Caitlin Nicole Tassin. Okima Chantel Terrell. Shayla Noel Thayer. Rosemary Huo Truong. Judy Neka Uganzi. Tamara Nicole Vital. Erin Nicole Wilrich.
For the Bachelor of Science in Physics and Mathematics, graduating summa cum laude, Fabian Dominique Garza. For the Bachelor of Science in Physics, with a second degree in Electrical Engineering, a graduate of the Rio Honors College and graduating summa cum laude, Kelly Irene May Townley-Smith. Aaron Blake Saharnik. For the Bachelor of Arts in Political Science, a graduate from the Rio Honors College and graduating summa cum laude, Amira Mohammed. Bachelor of Science in Political Science, graduating summa cum laude, Mason Blaine Garner. Tracy Lynn Henderson. Rex Aaron Johnson. Alice Matoshi. For the Bachelor of Arts in Psychology and English, graduating magna cum laude, Jorge Humberto Ortiz. Bachelor of Arts in Psychology, David R. Frederick. A graduate of the Rio Honors College and graduating summa cum laude, Dominique Joné Petway. Sydney Danielle Wandex. The Bachelor of Science in Psychology and Criminal Justice, Victoria Isabella Curtis. Bachelor of Science in Psychology, Alexander James Ball. A graduate of the Rio Honors College, graduating summa cum laude, Rachel Diane Bingham. Whitney Charnel Boykin. Graduating cum laude, Jackson David Wood Calhoun. Cum laude, Bethany Ann Davis. Angel Mario Fernandez. Graduating magna cum laude, Cortland Taylor Green. Edgar Ricardo Jimenez. Graduating magna cum laude, Whitney Marie Murdoch. Gift Nileko. Ashton Marie Wagner. For the Bachelor of Arts in Criminal Justice. Graduating magna cum laude, Cole Alexander Widrows. Graduating cum laude, Jennifer Lee Luna. Graduating cum laude, Jacqueline Andrea Mercado. For the Bachelor of Science in Criminal Justice, Taylor Grace Allen. La Quinta Deshaun Andrews. Graduating magna cum laude, Davy G. Bass. Ebony Jeray Betts. Summer Brenia Biscomp. Graduating summa cum laude, Patricia Bob. Tyranny Sadie DeCour. Furches Dufoni Jr. Carly Michelle Getches. Ashley Renee Hadnot. Darcy S. Harper. Samantha Harrison. Travion Devonte Henderson. Shiniqua J. Henry. Chastity Lachey Celeste Jacob. Daniel Cole Kemp. Felicia Michelle Lockhart. Martha Rochelle McDaniel. Toria Shaquille Munson. Refugio Navarro. Jacqueline Rose Patronella. Jenna Payton Perry. Graduating summa cum laude, Guadalupe del Carmen Pride. Michael Sean Scott Jr. Graduating summa cum laude, Jose Miguel Soto. Graduating summa cum laude, Jennifer L. Taylor. Jermaine Latrell Walls. Ryan Taylor Whitehead. Ashley Nicole Wright. For the Bachelor of Science in Sociology, April Angela Henderson. Jack Wayne Engel. Sylvia Marie Keeson. With a second degree in criminal justice and a graduate of the Rio Honors College, graduating summa cum laude, Sarah Danielle Tobin. Angelique Lorray Williams. For the Bachelor of Social Work, Jaleesa Marie Celestine. Jessica Marie Childs. Gra- Graduating summa cum laude, Santiago Agustin Signiliaro. Brandy Rose Crane. Debriqua Charnay Davis. Crystal Marie Dered. Victoria Lynette Franks. Posthumously awarded to Janet Lowe, and receiving the degree for Janet is her brother, Lucas Lowe. Dejene Catrice Pete. Kaylin Janice Pratt. Congratulations, graduates.
Please join me in congratulating our graduates one more time, please. And here's one of my favorite parts of the program. The Otho Plummer Award honors the baccalaureate graduate with the highest grade point average in her or his graduating class. During their undergraduate careers, tonight's seven honorees have completed 334 courses, all A's. Not even a slightest blip on the radar screen. Will the following graduates please come forward and receive your check and certificate from President Evans? Ms. Torrance Elizabeth Cobb, Bachelor of Arts in Modern Languages. Ms. Susharitha Marneni, Bachelor of Science in Biology. Ms. Susmitha Marneni, Bachelor of Science in Biology. Ms. Emily Erin McMillan, Bachelor of Science in Mathematics and Bachelor of Science in Chemical Engineering. Ms. Monica Lee Miller, Bachelor of Applied Arts and Sciences. Ms. Jordan Danielle Price, Bachelor of Science in Biology. Ms. Jennifer L. Taylor, Bachelor of Science in Criminal Justice. Graduates, today you join more than 80,000 others throughout the world who are Lamar alumni. I'd like to take this opportunity to extend to each of you an invitation to join Lamar's Alumni Association. Alumni membership provides continued involvement with the university, networking, and opportunities to help others, other students like you, achieve what you have achieved throughout your years at Lamar. I encourage you to join this important arm of the university. The Alumni Association certainly has friendly people waiting to greet you, and they will be in touch. Of course, you can always find them at Lamar's website. Please, please join. Thank you.
Again, congratulations to all of our graduates, and thank you to all of our guests for taking part in commencement with us. Exactly. Graduates, use and share your education to make a difference in your lives and in the lives of others. After the recessional, you are cordially invited to begin your celebration by joining us for a reception on the second floor concourse of the Mountain Center. Ms. Duke?
Please stand.